Paul here appeal for prayer. You'll notice, ye also helping together by prayer for us. And this is something that God wants to do for us, you see. And Paul appealed for prayer. And I went on radio and asked people to pray. And, oh, people have been praying down through the years. And I thank God for it. But I think he's done this so we can comfort others. And it's for the benefit of others. Comfort them that are in trouble. And it's been amazing how we've been able, and I just can't go to all of them have cancer. I just didn't know so many people had it. But I have been able to contact several, not many. And I went to see a man up in the San Joaquin Valley. And he had cancer. And his wife wrote me later and says, you don't know what it meant to him for you to come and tell how God had comforted you. Now he says God's comforted him. Oh, my friend, we are to do this. God permits us to have trouble today. Now, it's too bad when the world speaks too well of us. We ought to be very careful. Listen to him again. For we would not, brethren, have you ignorant of our trouble which came to us in Asia, that we were pressed out of measure, above strength, insomuch that we despaired even of life. And that's the thing that he says here. You remember the fable that we used to read, many of us, years ago in our reader at school? And it was how the sun and the wind were having a contest to see who was the strongest. And the wind said he could make, there was a man going down the street with his coat on. And the wind says, I can make him take that coat off, make him remove it. And so the wind began to blow. And I tell you, it almost blew the man away. But instead of taking his coat off, he just wrapped it around him a little closer. And then the sun says, it's my time to try. And so the sun began to shine down on him. And oh, it was so warm and nice. And he took that coat off and removed it. And the sun did it. Now, you know, trouble today, it won't generally take us away from God. I tell you, when the wind begins to blow and it gets rough and tough, we immediately want to turn to our Father who can comfort us. It's dangerous today when the church has it too easy and when Christians have it too easy and the sun is shining on them. They remove that robe of practical righteousness and they begin to compromise with the world. And that's exactly what many have done today.